Dear friends of Powershoots TV, positive energy in Europe. Today I'm in the European Parliament in Brussels, and it's really my pleasure to welcome the member of the European Parliament, Gesine Meissner. Welcome.
Hello.
So, your working field is very large. You work on environment, transport, food. Please explain us a little bit what are you doing and how we as citizens benefit of your work.
Yeah, I do actually a lot of different topics for the people in Europe, everywhere in the member states. I can just take one example of what I do right now. I'm working on a special legislation for health technology assessment.
Good.
It seems to be quite complicated, but I can explain it in simple words.
Yes.
It's just that a medicine that's good for people and it's maybe better than the one we have already in place is only tested and certified once in Europe, not
okay.
in all the member states.
Mm-hmm.
Additionally, and that of course is a lot more efficient, and then all the member states, even the smaller ones, the people who live there can profit of that. That's
so the medicine comes
thing
quicker
for all the people in
it comes quicker.
It comes quicker and it only has to be tested once.
Okay.
Once for a whole Europe and instead of 27 or 28 or how many times.
Yes.
And that's of course much more efficient. So it can be that a new medicine is quicker on the market and can help you sooner.
Maybe
it's better for your health, and so on. Maybe it's cheaper even.
So we gotta see. But it's a good news, yes.
I think, yeah.
Because you have other good news, that's why I'm here. Because you work a lot on maritime policy and you have been, you can be proud, by the President Tajani, himself in the European Parliament, that you will be a little bit the ambassador of a, you will give the information about the whole maritime policy, for sure the pollution of the ocean. Please explain us a little bit what it is.
Yes, I'm absolutely really proud of that. I'm working since a couple of years on maritime issues, and I founded myself a so-called intergroup, Seas, Rivers, Islands and Coastal Areas, in the Parliament 2015, and we do every month we do an event on ocean issues.
Okay.
And the group is really on the sustainable development of our blue planet sources.
Uh-huh.
And that's meanwhile the president got to know that, and he thought it must be much more prominent for me as a president as well to take care of the ocean.
Yes.
And since I don't know that much, although he's Italian,
yeah.
he should know something, he appointed me as special envoy of the Parliament's president for maritime affairs. So
right.
I shall give him advice on maritime things.
Yes.
And tell him what's going on and discuss with him what should be done in the Parliament.
Yes.
Besides in international conferences, I can represent him as Parliament's president.
Because now me as a citizen, my main question is, we know all, we see the pictures in the news, the ocean is polluted, there's a really huge pollution, plastic and so on. But then I say, okay, if we do it good in Europe, but the main pollution comes from India, from China, and when how we have a chance to find a solution? I think there are so many projects at the moment also, and it's in the mind of people that we see that we have to change, we take care not to use too much plastic, but the main problem is outside Europe, very far outside. How can we manage this?
That is right, but it's not that the people outside of Europe are sleeping. They are aware of this problem as well.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I managed to have an international exhibition on plastic pollution in the sea here in April. It was created for the G7.
Mm-hmm.
It was mainly paid by the German Ministry for Research and Education. And it was first in Torino. And as soon as I heard about that last year, I thought this must go to the European Parliament. It must be shown to Belgian people. And so I really managed together with my team. I have a very good team
to get it
here. And it was first in Turin, then in Paris, then in Brussels for 10 days. And then it went to Washington and Ottawa. In Berlin, it still had not been, although it's paid from over there. And this is about the amount of pollution we have in the ocean. And it showed as well possibilities to cure it, so to say. For example, one of my special guests in the conference, it was Milati Weissen from Bali.
Mm-hmm.
She's a 17-year-old girl from Bali, from the island in Indonesia. And she told me when she was 12 and her sister was 10, they were in school, in a so-called green school. And then they were asked, can you consider about something you maybe can do for society?
Yeah.
And as example, they had big names like Martin Luther King or Nelson Mandela or Mother Teresa. And so they thought about it, we have such a lot of plastic on our beaches, we want to get rid of that. And then they created plastic-free Bali. And really, they managed to be so active and so convincing to other people that meanwhile it's a big movement in Bali, and that is Asia, and there's a lot of pollution over there. And they really managed to collect garbage at the beaches, and now they have laws in Indonesia and Bali, and they don't have really now a plastic-free Bali, but they are on a good way to achieve that. And I can just, I even can show it, I don't know whether it's to be seen for here, but here it's a little girl. There she is. So she had been here, and another young lady as well, Olga. She came from Moscow, and she is creating. She is a researcher on the one hand side, and besides, she creates out of the plastic garbage from tea. She creates furniture. And so many good things can be done, and
by simple citizens. That's what I really like in the story. That you, everybody, can do really anything. These people are heroes, we can nearly say.
Exactly. I have to show it to everybody. It's Mission Plastic Free Ocean. It's written in German here, but it's in English. It's Mission Plastic Free Ocean, and we try to achieve that through the research program in the European Union. We hope that we can really do something, and now again, since you said the main problem arises in Asia, that's right. But we in Europe, we do have a lot of technology and knowledge, and I think it's our planet as well, not only the planet of the Chinese. And we do pollute as well, maybe not the same amount. We do more collection of waste and separation of waste, but we can be a good example, and besides, we are not perfect, and we should try to make even a business out of this and join with the rest of the world in order to have a better blue planet.
Great. I change completely the subject because you work on so many subjects. Here it's a positive channel. Just please give me from the past, present, future, just a little wrap up, but where you can come, for example, with a concrete example of your work, what you achieved yourself or with your team, where you can be very proud, and it's very good for citizens in Europe. That's why we believe in Europe.
Yeah, I could think of several things, but in this case, again, it's a maritime issue.
Okay.
Sorry about that,
okay.
But I work a lot for the sea, because really I was rapporteur and I managed to have, it sounds again very technical, a maritime spatial planning. That means concrete, if some more activity shall be done in the sea, in the ocean, like fishery, like aquaculture, like blue energy, wave energy installation, another offshore plant, whatever, a new shipping route, whenever something of that is planned, or blue biotechnology, then you should ask all the others who are in the same sea basin, so to say, what they do, what they plan, and then you try to figure out what really, how should it be done? Does it still fix in the plan? And so that the oceans are not overcrowded, are not overused, and everything can go smoothly. And this was a difficult thing to get through. It's now something that is shown as a good example everywhere in the world. It comes from Europe. And it was really difficult because the member states said, that's our competence, don't do that. And we know what to do with our sea, and the rest for Europe, it's not to be regulated. And I said, and I won finally, oceans and sea, water doesn't know any border. Fishes don't know of a border. Sure. And so it's a common responsibility to take care of that and to think about it.
And
quite often, and quite often, for example, it could be that offshore installation is just, with an example, Netherlands and Germany just at the border in the common sea spot. And so it's of course good to have a common strategy. And that is something really
I
thought I have to give up. I never give up.
No, we know
because the member states didn't know that, didn't want that, but finally really we achieved with the with help of a very good Greek man who was a negotiator for the council then, and with a Commissioner Damanaki, we three stick together and we manage it, and that is something to be proud of.
Chapeau, thank you. So very last question is not to the member of the parliament, it's to Gesine, the private person. Yes, what would you like to still to achieve in your life? I mean, in politics or even private, it's always to know a little bit who is behind this person.
Wow! To stay healthy, to have more grandchildren. I have already one granddaughter. And I really would like to contribute furthermore. to the health of the ocean, really, and the sustainable development of ocean resources. And I would like to make all the people love Europe. I'm absolutely convinced that is a good mission to have.
Perfect. That's what I'm trying to do. Thank you very much for your time and your positive energy.
Thank you,
and for sure for the ocean, for the for us, because we, if she takes care about the fish, we don't eat plastic fish.
I hope so.
So no, thanks everybody for listening.
Okay,
I wish you to enjoy it. Take care about your environment. Take care about the ocean, but take care also about the people around you. Be positive, distribute your positive energy, and all your dreams will come true. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.